the mystery. Many people say consciousness is the greatest mystery facing science today. But why? Isn't it obvious? This is consciousness? No, it's not, and the problem goes back to the philosophical problem called the mind-body problem, or in its modern incarnation, the hard problem of consciousness. We seem to have its subjective experiences that are private to ourselves. And yet we believe there is an external world that we can all see and feel and hear and touch. How can these two things relate to each other? How can a physical brain give rise to, create, be responsible for subjective experience? That's the mystery. Two, what is it like to be a bat? This weird question was asked by the philosopher Thomas Nagel in 1974, and it has become the closest thing we have to a definition in consciousness studies. If you ask, what is it like to be a cup? Well, nothing. There's nothing it's like to be a cup. It doesn't do anything or feel anything. But what about a bat? The idea is this. If there is something it's like to be a bat, something for the bat, the way things are for the bat, that's what we mean by being conscious. And if there's nothing it's like to be a bat, that's what we mean by not being conscious. Three, qualia. Philosophers talk about qualia, these qualitative aspects of our experience. So a qualia might be, for example, the redness of this red, or the green, blue, whatever this is, of this, the experience, the way it feels to hit myself, or the smell of coffee. These are all supposed to be qualia, and they're supposed to make up our experience. But others would say, well, that's a ridiculous notion. Experience isn't like that. You can't break it down into qualia, which is right. Four, the philosopher's zombie. I'm sitting here, and now imagine that there's another Sue sitting here. And she is, from the outside, indistinguishable in every way from the real Sue. She behaves and looks and acts and thinks and says the same things. But inside, she's quite different. She's not conscious. She's a zombie. There's nothing it's like to be zombie Sue. We can easily imagine such a thing, but could it exist? Some consciousness researchers say, of course it could exist. They must believe that consciousness is some kind of added extra that we might have or not have. We might have evolved to have it or not to have it. Others say that is completely wrong. Any creature that could do all these things and behave this way and think and see and feel and talk would have to be conscious by virtue of being able to do those things. Five, are other animals conscious? When I stood on my cat's tail, she yowled and ran away. And I'm convinced that she really felt pain. But did she? Behavior can be misleading. I could, for example, have a toy cat and put some mechanism in its tail so that when I stamped on it, it went meow. That wouldn't prove it was conscious. There are other methods, though. We can look at the anatomy. Other mammals, dogs and cats and even bats have similar anatomy to us, similar brain structures that make us think that probably they could feel pain. But then what about fish or caterpillars or octopuses? They have totally different anatomy, so we can't tell from that. One last way we might tell is the physiology. Experiments with fish show that they don't like even mild electric shocks and will swim away from them. But if you give them painkillers, the same sort that I might use for a headache, then they don't mind so much. So maybe they do feel pain. Six, altered states of consciousness. We all know what it's like to feel different. We sleep, we dream, even if we don't remember our dreams, and most of us have been inebriated at some time or another in our life. But it's not obvious to know what is altered in an altered state of consciousness, or even how to measure them. Do you take someone's word for it, how they feel? Do you look to see whether they've taken some drug or been hypnotized? It's not such an easy concept as we might have first thought. Seven, the neural correlates of consciousness. One of the most popular ways of studying consciousness is to ask which bits of the brain are responsible for when we're conscious of something or when we're not. So experiments might take something like this. Are you seeing a duck or a rabbit? And then look in the brain to see where things change. And we find that low down in the visual system, nothing changes, but higher up in the brain, things flip according to when you flip from duck to rabbit or back again. But does this really tell us where consciousness is arising in the brain? Eight, is consciousness all an illusion? That might seem ridiculous. I mean, I know I'm conscious, But the so-called illusionists don't say that consciousness doesn't exist or there isn't a problem. Rather, the idea is this. We have all these wrong notions about our own minds. We think our consciousness is something we have, that we control, that it has effects and is powerful and does things. But we may be completely wrong about that. So for an illusionist, our first task is to undermine all our assumptions about consciousness and start again in the hope that this way we might see through the mystery. 9. Free will. Consciousness and free will are closely related. I may feel as though I consciously decide to do something, and that's why I do it. But when we look in the brain, we don't see that this can happen. And indeed, we can see there's the decisions being made in different parts of the brain that explain why these actions happened. And the experiments also show that the conscious experience of deciding to act comes too late to be the cause of an action. So could free will be illusory? And if so, how do I live my life without believing in it? 10. The self. What is a self? I feel as though I'm inside here looking out. I'm the one who has free will, who is conscious. There's got to be a me. But when we look inside brains, we don't find anywhere that self could be, or indeed anything that it would be needed to do. So what is a self? Is it a construction of the brain, a representation of a self that doesn't exist, an illusion indeed? That's an interesting thought. Who am I?